In this video, we're gonna look at how I took these photos. I took them yesterday in Kew Botanical Gardens in London, UK. And I went to London for 3 days because sometimes I just love the feeling of getting away from everything and being completely by myself for a couple of days to immerse myself in my own thoughts and to just relax. So I went to London because there were cheap flights there and I haven't really explored the city for real before. And I thought it would be a great thing to do on a sunny, beautiful day like yesterday to go to the largest collection of plants in the world, I think. And this is based in Richmond in western London. And it's pretty easy to get there with a train and it doesn't take that long. The equipment that I use today are the usual things nowadays. A fold-up diffuser that I can have in my pocket, my A7 III camera, and the Laowa 60mm 2x macro lens. And this is a perfect setup. It fits in a very small bag and it's easy to use and it takes beautiful pictures. So Kew Botanical Gardens is huge. I spent 7 hours there. I walked 15,000 steps, 10 kilometers, and still I did not manage to see everything that there was to see. But I managed to get quite a few macro shots that I was very happy with. And this video is my little diary of these photos and my thoughts that I was thinking as I was taking them. The greatest joy when practicing any art, and the joy that drew me into photography for the first time, is the feeling of complete flow, complete immersion in what you're doing. The feeling when time stops and the only thing that exists is you and the subject you're trying to capture. And everything else you just forget. You forget where you are, you forget to eat, you forget to go to the bathroom. You are just completely immersed in the moment, and this can last for hours. And it was actually a while ago I was in this complete state of flow the last time, but today I managed to get into it and it was very, very enjoyable. Kew Botanical Gardens is not only a good place to go to do macro photography. They have something to see for everyone. They have great art installations and artworks. They have restaurants and cafes with very good food. And yeah, it's just an enjoyable place to spend a day. So I could recommend anyone to go there, even if you're not into macro photography. There are plenty of insects there, mostly quite common insects that I recognized from Sweden, such as hoverflies, bees, bumblebees, and flies of all different kinds. So there are not that many exotic or unusual bugs, but still there are plenty of bugs and insects and plenty of interesting creatures to photograph. And obviously there are a lot of different flowers from all over the world. So if you're into photographing flowers, it is also a perfect location. On this day, it was a bit windy, and that can be very frustrating when you're doing freehand macro photography. But you just need to be a bit patient. When it is windy, the wind that makes everything just swing back and forth usually only lasts for maybe 20 seconds and then there will be a brief pause and that is when you can take your photos. Usually the wind comes in waves, so just wait it out. A question I get asked quite often about macro photography is how you can avoid getting black backgrounds. How do you get a lot of colors in your background? And the reason you get black backgrounds is because your flash is a lot stronger than everything else. So since the flash mostly shines on your subject and not on the background, your subject will stand out and the background will be black. The easiest way to get colors in your background is to make sure to get the sky in the background, as the sky is usually very bright. And you can also try increasing the aperture a bit to maybe f5.6 or so, and then decreasing the strength of your flash. And decreasing the strength of the flash is a good thing because then it becomes faster and it can easily freeze your subject, and then you can actually lower the shutter speed to around 1/40th or 1/50th of a second and still get sharp images, and you will then get very colorful backgrounds. So experiment with increasing the aperture, lowering the shutter speed and decreasing the flash strength while trying to get the sky in the background, and you will get colorful, beautiful backgrounds in your macro photos. Most of the time when I'm photographing flowers, I prefer to have a large aperture and no flash, because I think the colors look better. But in many cases you can actually create pretty cool photos with a flash. Like this photo, for example, one of my absolute favorites from this day. When you visit a place like this, you will probably spend a lot of time walking around trying to find good spots to capture insects. And what you will find is that you will maybe spend most of your time at just 3 or 4 bushes with flowers, like this one. I spent maybe 30 minutes here just photographing insects, because the most interesting insects tend to flock to just a few spots. So you have to find these spots and then spend a lot of time there to get the best photos. I recommend you to always take a lot of photos. On this day I took 640 photos, and when I got back to the apartment I went through them a first time and I removed 540, so I had only 100 left. I removed all the ones that were obviously bad, that were out of focus, had bad compositions or badly exposed, or that I simply did not like. I usually do this very quickly. I just go through them, and if I don't love an image within the first second, I just remove it. And then on the second pass, after a break usually, I removed 80 more images. So in the end I only had 20 left, the ones you see in this video. And on the second pass I removed duplicates of photos I ended up keeping. I only want to have one version of each photo, the best version, and that is usually the one I pick in the second pass. So after two passes I had roughly 20 photos left that I ended up keeping, and this is about the ratio that I recommend you to have as well. If you take 700 photos, remove all but around 20 of them, and that is one of the key secrets of many photographers, that they take a lot of photos but they are very good at removing the ones that aren't good. And that is how you take good photos. I like the motto of a guy called Derek Sivers. He says, "Hell yeah or no." And that is how I also look at photo editing. If I don't feel hell yeah about a photo, I remove it. It is not worth it to be in my collection, and with this philosophy it becomes a lot easier to manage my archive of photos, because I only have ones that I really like, and I am pretty quick about removing the bad ones, usually within a day. So I always keep my archive fresh with photos I really like. You could almost say that it is the Con Murray method, but applied to photography. If a photo doesn't spark joy, it has to go. It was a lovely day at Kew Botanical Gardens, and after enjoying being in flow, in photography flow for hours, I went home and also had the wonderful feeling that I took a lot of good photos. I had this wonderful feeling you feel when you feel like you have a treasure in your memory card and you can't wait to get home and to discover how good the treasure actually is. So I didn't take maybe my life's best photos on this day, but I took quite a lot of photos that I am very happy with. I hope you didn't forget to sign up to my email newsletter on photography. Sign up at mwroll.com and get inspiration, tips about photo books, about gear, about great photographers once a month for free. Go check out my email newsletter. And please don't forget to leave a thumbs up, a like on this video if you did like it. It helps this channel a lot. And you are subscribed, aren't you? I really hope so, because I release new videos every week. And I am on Instagram. Check out my pictures at mwroll. That's it for this video. See you soon again. Over and out. Bye.